Today we are going to discuss anterior triangle of the neck part 2, means the second part of this lecture. In the previous lecture, in the anterior triangle of the neck, we have seen the surface landmarks, structure in the anterior median region of the neck and related anatomy. We have studied the two triangles in detail, that is the submental triangle and the digastric triangle. Today we will going to discuss about third triangle, that is the carotid triangle, and the fourth triangle, that is the, about the muscular triangle. Okay, so let's start. Okay, about the carotid triangle. Okay, in this figure you can see this is the carotid triangle. So what are the boundaries of the carotid triangle? Okay, you need to see this is one muscle, that is the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. This is the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and this muscle is the superior belly of omohyoid muscle. Okay, so this is the carotid triangle. So what are the boundaries of the carotid triangle? So here anterosuperiorly posterior belly of the digastric with the stylohyoid muscle, antero inferiorly this is the superior belly of omohyoid muscle, and posteriorly this is the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid muscle. The roof, that is formed by the skin, superficial fascia containing the platysma and the cervical branch of the facial nerve, transverse cutaneous nerves of the neck, investing layer of the deep cervical fascia that we have seen. Now we will see the floor, that is formed by the, here you can see one muscle. This is the middle constrictor of the pharynx. Here the two muscle, that is the this is the inferior constrictor muscle. Okay, the thyroid membrane. So this is the thyroid membrane. Middle constrictor of the pharynx, and this is the inferior constrictor of the pharynx, and this is the thyroid membrane. So this makes the floor of the carotid triangle. What are the contents of the carotid triangle? So here you can see in this figure there are so many contents, that is about the arteries, veins and the nerve, and also the lymph node. One by one we will see. First of all, what are the arteries in the carotid triangle? So as the name suggests, carotid triangle, there is a common carotid artery with the carotid sinus and the carotid body. Okay. Here in this figure, this is the common carotid artery, and this is the about carotid body, carotid sinus, internal carotid artery and the external carotid artery with its branches. Veins, about these are the internal jugular vein. Okay, this is the internal jugular vein. Common facial vein are there, lingual vein are there, and the pharyngeal veins are there. Okay, so these are the contents of the carotid triangle about the vein. Now this is the boundaries of the carotid triangle, in which there are the vagus nerve is there, superior laryngeal branch of the vagus are there, spinal accessory nerves are there, hypoglossal nerve, sympathetic chain, and also the carotid sheath with its content. Okay, so these are about the nerves in the carotid triangle. Also there is a lymph node, that is a deep cervical group of the lymph node. We will see some of the branches. What are the branches of the common carotid artery? So here in this figure, this is the common carotid artery, this is the internal carotid artery, and this is the external carotid artery. Common carotid artery that bifurcates at the upper margin of the thyroid cartilage into the internal carotid artery and the external carotid artery. The level, the vertebral level of the bifurcation of the carotid artery is in between the third and fourth cervical vertebra. So sometimes common or the MCQ question or one mark question, write down the vertebral level of the bifurcation of the common carotid artery. This is about, this is the upper border of the thyroid cartilage. Level is a C3 and C4. Carotid body. In this figure, this is a carotid body. What is carotid body? Carotid body, it is small, oval, reddish brown structure situated behind the bifurcation of the common carotid artery. That is supplied by 9, 10 and the sympathetic nerve. Okay, so here that is about the sympathetic nerve, and this is the 9th nerve, that is a glossopharyngeal nerve. Also there is a vagus nerve is going to supply, and the sympathetic nerve. It is chemoreceptor, responds to change in the oxygen, carbon dioxide and the pH content of the blood. That is about the carotid body. This is the carotid sinus. Carotid sinus, the termination of the common carotid artery or the beginning of the internal carotid artery. Okay, so in the beginning of the internal carotid artery, it is present. It is a slight dilatation known as the carotid sinus. It acts as a baroreceptor or the pressure receptor, regulates the blood pressure. Some of the, what are the branches of the external carotid artery? One by one we are going to see. Total, there are total 8 branches of the external carotid artery. We are dividing the external carotid artery into the anterior branch. In the anterior branch, that is a superior thyroid artery. What are the branches in the anterior? There is a superior thyroid artery. So here you can see this is the superior thyroid artery. After that, that is a lingual artery, and this is the facial artery. So these are the anterior branch, or you can say from the anterior aspect, the external carotid artery gives superior thyroid artery, lingual artery and the facial artery. Posteriorly, external carotid artery gives two branch, that is a posterior auricular artery and the occipital artery. This is the posterior belly of digastric in the upper border. This is a posterior auricular artery, and at the lower border you can see here the occipital artery. Medial branch, or from the medial aspect, this is the ascending pharyngeal artery, and the two terminal branch of the external carotid artery, one is a maxillary artery and last is a superficial temporal artery. So total 8 branch of the external carotid artery. One mark question, write down the branches of external carotid artery. First we will discuss superior thyroid artery. Here this is a branch, that is a superior thyroid artery. As the name suggests, it is going to supply the thyroid gland. Superior thyroid artery, it is along with the one nerve, that is the internal laryngeal nerve, branch of the superior laryngeal nerve. Here these are the branch of the vagus nerve. Here you can see the superior thyroid artery. This is superior thyroid artery having one branch. Okay, and this is the continuation, that is the superior thyroid artery. In In this figure also you can see this is a superior thyroid artery having the anterior branch and the posterior branch. You will also learn about the thyroid artery, that is superior thyroid artery and inferior thyroid artery, during the lecture of the thyroid gland. Okay, here you can see anastomosis between the superior thyroid artery and the inferior thyroid artery. Here you have to remember, with the superior thyroid artery, one of the branch, that is the external laryngeal nerve, is there. Second, lingual artery. So this is the lingual artery. This lingual artery course is divided into the three parts by the hyoglossal muscle. So this is the hyoglossal muscle. So this is the first part, up to here lies in the carotid triangle and it forms the one loop. This is a characteristic loop which is crossed by the hypoglossal nerve. Okay, so this is the first part. This lingual loop permits the free movement of the hyoid bone. Second part, that is lies below this muscle, that is the hyoglossus muscle. Third part is also called the arteria profunda lingula or deep lingual artery. Okay, so this is the third part. Here you can see, these are the first part, this is the second part, and this is the third. It gives so many branches, that is the suprahyoid and dorsal lingual and the sublingual artery. So you will learn this branch whenever you will see the term. Facial artery, you have learned in the lecture of the face. But this is the facial artery. So this is the tortuous. So many branches you can see. Submental artery, about inferior thyroid, inferior labial artery, superior labial artery, and the angular artery. In this figure also you can see this is a facial artery. About the occipital artery. Okay, this is the occipital artery, the posterior branch. You will see in the that is the occipital artery. In this figure also you can see this is the occipital artery. This is a suboccipital triangle. And from the posterior aspect or posteriorly, external carotid artery gives this occipital artery. Another posterior branch, that is a posterior auricular artery. It supplies the back of the auricle and the skin over the mastoid process. It also gives one of the branch, that is called the stylomastoid branch. Enter into the stylomastoid foramen, supplies the middle ear, mastoid antrum, air cells, semicircular canals, and the facial nerve. Medial branch, that is the ascending pharyngeal artery, going to supply the tonsil. Some of the other branches are also going to supply the tonsil. Medial ascending pharyngeal artery, medial branch of the external carotid artery, one of the branch of it also going to supply the tonsil. It is a small branch that arises from the medial side. It supplies, as the name suggests, pharynx. It sends meningeal branches into the cranial cavity through the foramen latrum, jugular foramen, and the hyoglossal canal. here you can see these are foramen lacrum and one of the branch, that is a meningeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. These are foramen lacrum. Foramen lacrum is present when we will study, when we will see the tutorial of the skull, that is the interior of the skull and various foramen. Maxillary artery is a larger terminal branch. Okay, this is a maxillary artery, larger terminal branch, or you can see this large terminal branch. You will see detail in the infratemporal fossa. Okay, that we will study later. Lastly, the terminal branch, that is a superficial temporal artery. It runs vertically upward, crossing the root of the zygoma or the preauricular point, where its pulsation can be easily felt. About 5 cm above the zygoma, it divides into anterior and posterior branch, which supply the temple and the skull. Anterior branch anastomosis with the supraorbital and supratrochlear branch. That is about the superficial temporal artery. Superficial temporal artery. This is about the superficial temporal artery. The branch, this is the frontal branch of the superficial temporal artery, and this is the parietal branch of the superficial temporal artery. Lastly, we will see what is the ansa cervicalis and what is ansa hypoglossi. Both are the same. Okay, this figure you can draw whenever asked in the exam. How it form, that we will now study. This figure is based for the understanding. Here you can see this is a C1 nerve, this is C2 and this is C3. So they are derived from C1, C2 and C3. From the C1, here this is a branch, one of the branch along with the C1. This is called the descendant hypoglossi. Okay, from C2 and C3, this is descendant cervicalis. So this is called, this portion is called the ansa cervicalis. Okay. So this portion is called the ansa cervicalis. Here you can see the one curve, that is the ansa cervicalis. This is the thin nerve loop that lies in the anterior wall of the carotid sheath, and it supplies the infrahyoid muscle. That infrahyoid muscle are the content of the muscular triangle. We will see later on. So it is formed by the superior root and the inferior root. So this is the superior root, that is derived from the C1, and inferior root, that is derived from the C2 and the C3. The superior root is continuous as a branch of the hypoglossal nerve, and its fiber is derived from the C1 nerve, that is going to supply the geniohyoid and the thyroid. But from there is a descendant hypoglossi that joins with the descendant cervicalis. So this portion, this is called the ansa cervicalis, and that is going to supply the sternohyoid and sternothyroid muscle. Here, superior root supplies the omohyoid, and this is the inferior root supplies the inferior belly of omohyoid. So this is all about the ansa cervicalis or ansa hypoglossi. Lastly, we will see muscular triangle. Here, this is the muscular triangle. This is the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. This is the superior belly of the omohyoid, and this is the anterior midline. So this triangle is a muscular triangle. In the muscular triangle, there is a content is a are all the infrahyoid muscle are present in the muscular triangle, as the name suggests, muscular triangle. So here, what are the muscles in the muscular triangle? The muscles are omohyoid muscle, superior belly of omohyoid. This is the inferior belly of the omohyoid muscle. Here, sternohyoid muscle, as the name suggests, sterno and hyoid muscle. Another muscle, thyrohyoid muscle, from the oblique line of the thyroid cartilage to the hyoid bone, thyrohyoid muscle. And another muscle, sternothyroid muscle. These are the four muscles you have to remember in the content of the muscular triangle. We have discussed about the last two triangles, that is the carotid triangle and the muscular triangle. In the carotid triangle, we have seen the branches of the external carotid artery. Thank you.